Hey friends, today we are going to do the characteristics of William Cooper's writing. What are the special features of William Cooper's writings? We are going to see here. So, point number one is William Cooper was born in 1731. His birth was of 1731. He occupies a distinctive place in English poetry. And he carries a distinctive place. Distinctive means a different, very important kind of place in English poetry. Now, next point is, he is the best representative of the transition from Augustan values to Romanticism. And he is the best representative of transitional period from Augustan values to Romanticism. Augustan values, that means he belongs to Augustan period and till his time goes to Romanticism. So there is a certain transition in his poetry where all the characteristics of Augustan period is also visible till the values of Romanticism. Now, point number three, he belongs to the group of transitional poets like Thomson, Blake, Gray and Collins. And he comes in the group of transitional poets like Thomson, Black, Gray and Collins, whose period falls between the age of Pope and the age of Wordsworth. So why he was called a transitional poet? Because his period falls between the age of Pope and the age of Wordsworth. Wordsworth, who is a romantic poet. Now, point number four. These poets are called transitional poets because they carry with them the characteristics of 18th century poetry. And why these all the poets like Thomson, Blake, Gray and Collins, and including our today's author or today's topic's author, who is William Cooper, why they are called transitional poets? Because they carry with them the characteristics of 18th century poetry. And what are the characteristics of 18th century poetry? These are want of emotion, because they used to show that why there is a need of emotions in the poetry, and they used to stress on reason, why something is happening, what's the reason behind something, and nature of man. They used to show what is the proper nature of man. Devotion to form and medium of heroic couplet, and that was the prominent feature of 18th century, that they used to devote their poetry to focus on the form and medium of heroic couplet. And also they foreshadowed the qualities of romantic revival of the 19th century. And here in this point we are discussing how and why they are called transitional poets, because they have the prominent features who were quite reflective in their poetry. Those were related with 18th century, and so as they have foreshadowed the qualities of romantic revival of the 19th century, so it is a perfect blend of 18th and 19th century, or the starting of 19th century. And that's why qualities of romantic revival is also there in their poetry. Now, next point is, Cooper has written several sad poems full of personal anguish, and he has written several sad poems. Melancholic tone is there. And why personal anguish? Because when he was 6 years old, he lost his mother. So it was quite reflective. His personal anguish, anxiety was quite reflective in his poems, like The Castaway and On the Receipt of My Mother's Picture are well-known poems of this kind. And melancholic poems are there. Lot many are written by many of other poets also. And two are given here which were so famous, and these are written by this poet William Cooper. Now, point number six, Cooper's strength as a poet lies in description and sentiment. And what was the strength of Cooper? And it was description. Why? Because द पोएम्स वर सो डिस्क्रिप्टिव एंड लॉट मेनी इंफॉर्मेशंस आर गिवन इन हिज पोएम्स एंड इट इज़ अबाउट सेंटिमेंट्स, इट इज़ अबाउट इमोशंस. His range is limited both by his temperament and his experience, but the range is so limited both by his temperament. Temperament means what is the nature of poet, what kind of poetry he likes to write. So due to that he was having limitations and due to his experiences. Now next point, no one before had described so well the sights and pleasures of domestic life in the country. Now it's a very prominent feature of his poetry that he used to describe the sights and pleasures of domestic life in the country. So in that way he is so near with the poems of Wordsworth, because he was also writing about the nature and about the loveliness of nature and how nature is so near to us. So he also talks about the pleasure of domestic life in the country and what are the features of domestic life, that what is the beauty of the warm fire, the hissing tea urn, when the tea is made, what kind of sound is produced, the arrival of letters, what kind of emotions are arised when the arrival of letters is there, the silent countryside under its load of snow, and how there is a silence when the city or the countryside is under the load of snow. Now next point is, Cooper is not considered a great poet. Here let me tell you friends that he was not considered a great poet. He is a minor poet. Minor means his poetries or his writings were of lesser importance, but who must be read. But it is quite sure that the writings of Cooper should be read. Not to know him is to miss a creative character and engaging combination of lovableness, simplicity and charm. And if you are not knowing him, if you are not reading his poems, you are missing a creative character and engaging combination of lovableness, simplicity and charm, which was reflective in his poems. So here friends, we have seen so many points which you can include when the question of William Cooper comes, be it his poems analysis, be it his life, be it his works. So you can include all these points, that he was born in 1731, he has a distinctive place, he was the representative of the transition period, and he shows the characteristics of Augustan period, and so as the characteristics of Romanticism. He falls under the category of transitional poets like Thomson, Blake, Gray and Collins, and he belongs to the age of Pope and as well as the age of Wordsworth. And transitional poets, why they are called transitional poets? Because they have the characteristics of 18th century as well as the category or the period of Romanticism. And here I have mentioned the particular prominent features of 18th century, which are also learnt by you, so that you can mention wherever it is necessary. And what are the features of 18th century, why there was the want of emotion, why they used to stress on reasons, nature of man, and how they used to focus on the form and medium of heroic couplet. And after that, if the question comes with the poems of Cooper, you can mention the poems are The Castaway, which is so famous, and one more is there, On the Receipt of My Mother's Picture, which is an elegy. Elegy means something is written on the death of someone near or dear, and it's like a commemoration, it's like a tribute to someone whom we love. Now next is, what are the strengths of Cooper, that he believes in description and sentiments. Then after that we can write why his poetry has limitations and why it was based on his temperament and his experience. But it is written that he was known for its description of sights and pleasure. How he used to show the warm fire, the hissing of tea urn in his poems. But it is written here that no matter he was a minor poet, he was not having greater importance in the English poetry. But we should know the creative character, engaging combination of lovableness, simplicity and charm which was there in his poem. For that, we should read the poems of William Cowper. Okay friends, that's it for this video. If you have liked the video, subscribe my channel and keep watching. Okay, bye-bye.